right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. Joining me now, Jim McDonald, the CEO of Kootenay Silver. And Jim, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Good to be back, Steve.
Yeah, every time you and I talk, it seems when you have results from the Columba Silver Project in Mexico, they get better and better and better. And these numbers you're releasing today on these three holes, very impressive. So I'll let you talk about where they are and really what you saw.
Yeah, so it's more off of the D vein. That's where this program is solely focused on expanding the widest and highest grade intervals we've hit to date on Columba. So we previously released three holes with some incredible results, the best of which was 13.5 meters of almost 600 grams per ton silver and a core of 8 meters at 858. Now we're following up with the next three holes, and the best hole here is just 5.67 meters of 510 gram per ton silver with a nice 2.3 meter interval of 1142. So these are all step outs from previous hits of similar high grades and really good widths. So we're just expanding the footprint of this really nice mineralized zone.
Yeah, this D vein just keeps on giving, it seems. It continues along. And you've talked about in the past that this is obviously a pretty important one in the overall scheme of what you're trying to do.
Yeah, well, it is. We've got multiple veins there, numerous of which have good grade and good widths on them. The D vein has provided the best grades and widths to date. So we're working on building a volume and size and continuity here on this program. And the key to these vein systems, these epithermal vein systems, is typically you'll have a swarm of different veins, and typically you'll have just a few of those veins, sometimes only one or two, that'll make up the bulk. Over 50% of the total ounces of the projects. And it's those zones that really make everything else you find work. And that's why we're focused on this D vein. It could be one of those zones. And the results we're hitting so far certainly are supporting that to date.
Now, you and I have mentioned, or at least you've mentioned to me in the past, that you're looking at a maiden resource by the end of 2024. I'm sure you've put a lot of holes in the ground, a lot of work going on. And so are you getting questions about, you know, what are you else you're going to be doing in 2024 that leads you into that end of the year maiden resource?
Yeah, well, it's going to entail a bunch more drilling. So expansion certainly on the D vein. Because by the end of this program, we'll probably have looked at about 500 meters of strike length. And we've got at least double that or even more of strike extent to test on that vein. Then there'll be some infill. And then there's other veins like the F vein we need to follow up on as well. We've got 700 meters of strike length and consistent hits on the F vein as well. So, you know, what will be required is at least another 20,000 meters of drilling, a whole bunch more holes here to get enough size and continuity established, enough density of drilling to be able to do a maiden resource.
All right. Well, we'll leave it there. We'll look forward to our next conversation and more results coming from the project. Jim, thank you so much. Good to talk to you.
Thank you, Steve.
All right. Jim McDonald, the CEO of Kootenay Silver.